Welcome to the Shrimpy YouTube channel, a place where you can learn everything about the disruptive sector of cryptocurrencies and finally start building your blockchain education. In today's video, we will explore the risks of hosting an Ethereum 2.0 node. It's believed that staking will completely replace mining and introduce a new wave of scalable blockchain networks that can support demand at the level of financial giants such as Visa. But to what lengths will node operators go when there are so many risks involved with staking? The Ethereum blockchain enforces a strict rule where users have to stake at least 32 Ether in order to be eligible for a node operator position. With the rising value of cryptocurrencies, it's obvious that the risks will continue becoming more and more of a threat. Thankfully enough, developers are working on practical solutions, but before we search for alternative methods, let's first take a clear look at the risks of personally hosting a node. Blockchain technology is often thought to be too complicated for the average user. While that may not always be true, it's definitely the case when it comes to staking. Hosting a node on the Ethereum 2.0 network is no easy task, considering that less technically minded users are bound to get burned as a result of slashing, a process in which the blockchain network takes a portion of your assets. Hosting a node is, in fact, so difficult that we can think of investing and day trading cryptocurrencies as being easy. After all, smart contracts are incredibly complex, and it takes real commitment and background knowledge to even begin understanding how Ethereum works. Slashing occurs when a node operator behaves maliciously or does not process a task like he's supposed to do. The mistakes range from spamming the blockchain with fake transactions to temporarily going offline. Whether you've made a mistake intentionally or not does matter, given that Ethereum treats all bad actors equally. While slashing does ensure that absolutely everyone acts in good faith, it can be detrimental to those who make a mistake as a result of external factors. Let's say that a heavy storm cuts off your internet connection or destabilizes your local power grid. Turning your node back online does not depend on a personal choice, but on external circumstances, which means that you'll face losses unless a backup plan is there to save you. Even if someone's node does work flawlessly and without any interruptions, there are still a number of security risks that expose node operators to danger. For example, everyone who stakes has a set of validator keys that must be kept secure. If they're lost or forgotten, the operator loses access to all of his assets. Slashing becomes much worse in this event, considering that the node will be offline for far longer. If you don't recover your keys on time, the network will simply slash half of the staked assets and remove your node altogether. If you're enjoying this video so far, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more crypto content. Another way of losing money while staking occurs when a hacker gains access to your validator keys. The anonymous individual can simply decide to steal your Ether or to attack the blockchain by spamming fake transactions. Considering that Ethereum node operators now stake around $70,000 worth of crypto assets, exposing yourself to so many risks is no laughing matter. If you decide to personally host a node, these risks will sadly always exist, but it doesn't have to be that way. Back in the age of proof of work, miners would join up and create pools in which everyone would contribute their hardware power. This allowed miners to have a better chance at receiving block rewards and earning more coins. Today, stakers will have to embark on a similar journey in order to fare better on the blockchain. Staking pools on Ethereum 2.0 are excellent alternatives for those who either do not have the skills to host a node or don't wish to expose themselves to risks. These pools are hosted by decentralized staking platforms that enable users to stake virtually any amount of ETH by joining forces with other community members. The best part is that staking pools are completely automated and that they require no interaction from the user apart from depositing cryptocurrencies. They also delegate security and slashing risks to the platform, which gives investors peace of mind, which no other form of staking can offer. Rocket Pool is the best example of a great staking pool for Ethereum. It facilitates a special kind of third-party staking process that enables Ether holders to support the blockchain without having to personally host a node. While slashing is not fully avoided, it is minimized to some degree with the help of socialized risk. Socialized risk is a design in which slashing is distributed equally to the entire staking pool rather than just one person. Everyone gets to share the burden of one individual's mistake, and in return, slashing losses become practically negligible. Since Rocket Pool uses smart contracts, it is fully decentralized and there is no risk of losing your assets. Their contracts are open source, meaning that everyone can confirm that the rules and tasks implemented are not malicious and that stakers can trust the platform. Another game changer is the fact that Rocket Pool tokenizes staking. What this essentially means is that everyone's share in a staking pool is represented by an ERC-20 token, which can be used or sold at any time. The benefit of this business model is that stakers will not have their assets locked up, which is the case for traditional node operators. After depositing Ether to Rocket Pool, users receive RETH tokens in return. This is a token that represents the user's stake and yield, just like how a liquidity pool token represents a yield farmer's activity. RETH can be stored on a hardware wallet, used in other DeFi products, or even be sold on a crypto exchange. Considering that markets are volatile and that crashes can happen at any point in a bull market, this feature allows users to completely eliminate the risk of having their hands tied when staking on Ethereum. Apart from removing all kinds of risks, staking pools also automate the process and enable investors to spend more time on other crypto activities. In light of everything that we've talked about so far, participating in staking pools seems to be a wiser option. Slashing is a nefarious process, and the only way to evade it is by using a platform like Rocket Pool or by paying a hosting service to power your node and keep it online. Since hosting creates an even more centralized experience and is still not safe from harm, the decision boils down to only one option. So what do you think? How serious are staking risks? And is there a project that did a better job at offering third-party staking services? Let us know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and click the red subscribe button to join our crypto community. You can find us on Twitter and Instagram at ShrimpyApp and on our blog at blog.shrimpy.io. And make sure you head to the link in our description box to get access to our free and updated white paper.